Kelly?
All right, thanks a lot, Jamie. It is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and we are teamed up with the MedStar Health Cancer Network. Dr. Maen Farha, breast surgeon, director of the new Comprehensive Breast Center at Good Samaritan Hospital, joining us in the studio now. Doctor, thanks so much for coming
back. Oh, thank you for inviting me.
Tell us, DCIS, I know it's kind of a form of cancer, but tell us what it is.
It stands for ductal carcinoma in situ, which means the cancer cells are contained within the duct. This means that's a stage zero cancer.
Okay.
It does not have a chance to spread to the lymph nodes or the rest of the body. So the cure rate for DCIS should be near 100% if it's discovered and treated properly.
Now, is it something that I should worry about?
Well, if you do your screenings, it's usually found out by screening mammography because these tumor, these lesions are too small to detect by exam. The vast majority of patients who have DCIS are found on routine mammography. They're often calcium deposits or small masses that are seen on mammography. On occasion, it's a palpable abnormality, something that the patient may feel.
Mm-hmm.
But the vast majority are found on screening mammography.
So when I would go to get my mammogram, this might be something that they'd recognize?
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
How do you treat it?
The focus on treating DCIS is on the breast itself. We don't have to worry about lymph nodes. We don't have to worry about the rest of the body. So the patients are treated usually with a lumpectomy, and in the majority of cases with radiation. Nowadays, we do partial breast or intraoperative radiation for those, especially if it's well localized. And then, since these patients are at a higher risk of getting another cancer or a recurrence, they may go on hormonal therapy, which is like tamoxifen and estrazoles. These are medications that are taken for 5 years or more to prevent the occurrence of another cancer.
That was my next question. What's the likelihood of it developing into a full-blown cancer?
Left alone, it has a good chance of turning into a full-blown cancer. If it comes back, half the time it's invasive cancer.
Okay.
So it's good not to take it lightly, but you don't want to get too worried about it, but deal with it. I think patients will do very well.
Are there new methods to treat it now? What's new in care for this type of cancer?
You know, there are research studies looking at the genetic makeup of these tumors to figure out which ones need radiations, which ones don't need radiation. And I think the hormonal therapies and these interventions make a big difference in preventing these tumors from coming back.
Always great information from Dr. Farha. Thanks so much for coming in. One of our many experts here that we have with us in the studio is we're taking house calls. The number to call is 410-481-2222. We're going to be on the line with our experts from MedStar Health Cancer Network until 6:30. So if you've got a question, now is the time to call in and get an answer from an expert like Dr. Farha.
Thank you.
Thank you. All right.